today I'm going to tell you who the best brawlers are specifically for beginners to Brawl Stars, because it is very different at that level. So let's get into it. Alright, so I wanted to do a brawler ranking specifically for beginners because I do think it's a really, really different game down at the early stages of Brawl Stars. First of all, you're missing a lot of brawlers. You're not probably facing many legendaries, mythics, or even epics, and a lot of the brawlers you're facing don't have their star powers, or let alone they're not even like very high level. So with those things in mind, I wanted to do a brawler ranking that doesn't include any legendaries, doesn't include any mythics, doesn't include any epics, and also it's geared towards not having your star power. So this is the brawler ranking for beginners. Also keep in mind too, some of these brawlers are going to be ranked higher specifically based on how beginners play. For instance, in a lot of times with low trophy games, especially with randoms, you find a lot of people running down the middle and grouping up and making aggressive plays. Also, they're probably using auto aim a lot and they might not be very good at aiming. So with those things in mind, those are all going to be important factors in this ranking. Let's start at the bottom of this ranking. There's going to be 14 brawlers that we're going over. At number 14, what I think is the worst or the hardest brawler to play for beginners, it's going to be Bo. Bo definitely going to be at the bottom of my list, partly because his star power is so important for his success. The main reason he's good on specific maps is because his star power is so strong there. But if you're a beginner to Brawl Stars, you just got Bo, he's not going to be anywhere close to max, so he's not going to be nearly that good. He does have a lot of health, which is a little forgiving, but he doesn't do that much damage, so you get in a tight spot. You're probably not going to get out of it very easily, and you're going to be getting in those spots, especially since you don't have his star power and you can't see people coming. So Bo's going to be the worst brawler for beginners for me. The next worst brawler for beginners for me, it's going to be Daryl. Daryl especially is a hard brawler to play, and also without his star power is definitely important for getting really easy kills or for just rolling in on people and not dying that quickly. So star power matters, but he's also a hard brawler to master. A lot of people do not understand how to use Daryl well. Definitely check out my Daryl guide if you are still one of those people, so you can turn that trash can into a real assassin. He's actually not bad brawler once you learn how to use him, but for beginners to the game, he is definitely a bit of a high skill cap brawler, and without his star power, he's not gonna be nearly as good. So he's gonna be the second worst beginner brawler for me. The third worst beginner brawler for me is actually going to be Dynamite. I really like Dynamite. He has some really strong abilities, but he's not the easiest to aim, I feel like, especially for people who are new to the game. And he's really bad with auto aim, and a lot of beginner brawlers, beginner people, are not used to aiming well. And on top of that, they don't save their shots well, which is really important with Dynamite, because if you are constantly using all of your ammo, you will not be getting hits, because he's kind of easy to dodge if you're only throwing one shot at a time, and it's all kind of slow, because you're just waiting to reload every shot. So Dynamite, a little bit hard to master. A lot of people too probably get too close to enemies, don't use walls nearly as well, aren't as good at keeping their distance, which are all really important things for Dynamite to be strong. He's still a decent brawler, but especially for beginners, and he's not the strongest brawler right now, he's gonna be my third worst for beginners. At number 11, it's gonna be Ricochet. Ricochet without his star power, not quite as good. It definitely helps you get a lot of shots with him, but also Ricochet is a bit of a high skill cap brawler, I feel like. You don't really wanna auto aim with him much because you wanna be bouncing your shots off the wall, so you gotta learn how to aim well with Ricochet. On top of that, you gotta know the angles, and you gotta know the angles for every single map. Ricochet is a brawler where experience matters a lot because you have to have experience on all these different maps to know exactly where those bounce angles are, and you can just remember them right away as opposed to just totally guessing, like, oh, I wonder if this angle is going to hit this person in that area over there. No, if you know those right away, you have a really big advantage. So Ricochet skill cap matters a lot. Also, his star power definitely has an impact on how good he is. He's also a little bit of a hard brawler to master in general, so he's going to be at 11. At 10, it's going to be Jesse. Jesse definitely benefits from people in earlier trophy levels from grouping up a ton, because she can get those easy bounce shots. But without her star power, she's not quite as good. Her star power is definitely really important for Jessie's success because her turret is a big part of how strong Jessie is. On top of that, her star power really, really helps that happen. And you can also get even more damage with bouncing shots off your turret and getting hits on enemies. So she does benefit from people grouping up, but at low power levels, she doesn't do a lot of damage per shot. And without her star power, she's not nearly the same threat and doesn't have the same amount of control as you would want out of a low health sort of gem carrier type brawler. At 9, it's going to be Barley. Barley is a little bit of a high skill cap brawler, not quite as much as Dynamite, but if you're not saving your shots well with Barley, you're not going to be controlling lanes well with Barley, which is the main thing you want to be doing with him. On top of that, his star power is really good, actually, so that definitely helps a lot, especially for newer players. If you have a star power, it's much more forgiving to play Barley with his star power than without. If you are a little bit less experienced, you can help just keep on attacking people, survive different situations. Even if you're low health, you're not in the end of the world because you can heal up a little bit with his star power. But without it, that doesn't happen. You do still benefit from people grouping up a lot, which definitely helps a lot with Barley. So that's actually pretty good for him. But without his star power, he's going to be a little bit less, and he's a little bit hard to master because you can't be just using one shot at a time. You have to be controlling and methodical and trying to guess where people are going and using one or two shots and trapping them and getting more damage that way with Barley, which a lot of new people probably aren't very good at. He's also not very good with auto-aim. At 8, it's going to be Penny. And honestly, Penny is this high because her cannon is so good, and you don't have to do anything with her cannon. It doesn't matter how good you are at Brawl Stars, her cannon is still going to be good. You just put it in a position that isn't horrible, and it should be fine. You should be able to get some hits. Just place it far enough back that it's going to get shots off, and it's not going to die right away, and you're going to be okay with Penny. She's also okay with auto-aim. She's not very good at low power levels, especially in, like, Showdown or Duo Showdown, because she does no damage. Hardly any damage, and she cannot carry teams. But her cannon does not take any skill, so Penny is actually a pretty easy brawler to play for beginner. At 7, it's going to be Colt. Colt is definitely a bit of a high skill cap brawler, but his power level doesn't matter that much, and of my opinion, and his star power also isn't that important for you to be successful with Colt. You can auto-aim okay with Colt. It's not horrible, but it's also not that great. If you want to be best with Colt, you shouldn't be auto-aiming, but you can do okay with him, especially compared to some other brawlers for beginners. He can dish out a ton of damage, though. Also, part of the reason auto-aim with Colt is okay at lower trophy levels is a lot of people don't know how to dodge well, so they're not able to dodge those Colt shots really well. You have more people running just like straight forwards and straight backwards at earlier trophy levels, which is where the auto-aim works really well with Colt. Otherwise, if they start to learn how to dodge, it's not going to be nearly as good, but for beginners, it can work okay, and Colt is not... He's a very simple brawler for how to play. You know what your objective is with Colt. You're going to try and keep your range. You know you're a damage dealer. You're not going to be doing anything really fancy with Colt. So he's not too hard at the end of the day. And number 6 is going to be El Primo. He's definitely a pretty easy brawler to play for beginners. Or just in general, he's a really easy brawler to play. You can auto-aim with him. No problem, easy peasy, and also it's a fairly straightforward brawler to play. There is a skill cap with him as far as dodging shots and getting close to enemies, but a lot of people at beginner levels are also not very good at staying away from enemies, which is great for El Primo because he can just run on in, and you can auto-aim his attack, you can auto-aim his super. Honestly, it's not a big deal for auto-aiming his super because you're at least going pretty close to someone. Auto-aiming jumps isn't the end of the world, except for Piper, of course. But El Primo is a pretty easy brawler to play, and a lot of people do not keep their distance well versus El Primo, or just in general at beginner levels. So he's definitely going to be a solid beginner brawler to play. At 5, it's going to be Brock. Brock may not be the easiest brawler to master, but he's a really solid brawler overall, and that range really helps him. He's okay with auto-aim. You don't want to be auto-aiming his super, although for beginners, it honestly might be just as successful as manually aiming because it's not the easiest super to manually aim. You can definitely end up missing a lot of them if you're new at Brock. So Brock is not the easiest brawler to play, but he's really good in a lot of different things. So he's a solid brawler in general to play. He's going to do well. He matches up well versus a lot of different brawlers. So he's definitely a good brawler, which is the main reason he's higher on this list. He's not that bad for beginners, and you can auto-aim his shots really easily in close range, which can work out pretty well with Brock, especially if you're, say, in Showdown, and you have a decent amount of power, but you can actually get away a lot with auto-aim in any short and medium range with Brock. Otherwise, though, you don't really want to be, but he's still going to be not that bad. At 4, it's going to be Bull. Bull, I mean, look, he's an auto-aim brawler. He's really easy to play in general. I mean, of course, you got to learn how to dodge people, but similar to El Primo, there's a lot of things that he's just... You hide in the bush, and you can do pretty well with Bull in Showdown and other beginner situations, as long as you're hiding, being patient. Now, his super is not good at all with auto-aim, so I would definitely not recommend that. But it's also not a hard super to manually aim either. It's not that difficult. You know in general where you're trying to go. It's a straight line thing. It's not that hard. You can predict a little bit, but it's not that big of a deal. So Bull, I mean, yeah, he's an auto-win brawler. He's pretty easy to play, and he's pretty good in general, too. So he's going to be a good beginner brawler. All right, and number three, it's going to be Shelly. I mean, look, Shelly, really similar to these other ones. Shelly's an auto-aim queen, I guess you could say. And at the beginner levels, that is really... that's all you need, okay? Especially with a brawler like Shelly sitting in the bush. Also, you can see Bull's high on this list, how Primo's high on this list. Shelly destroys them. And you, there are a lot of tanks at beginner levels. People just run around, think tanks are super strong because people don't know how to keep their distance. And Shelly is the counter to them all, which rises her to the top of this list. You also don't need her star power. You don't need a high power level with her. If you can get her super, you can destroy tanks, and it's just pretty dang easy. So Shelly is a good beginner brawler. At number two, though, this brawler is not an amazing brawler, but versus beginners, oh my god, he becomes, honestly, feels like insanely powerful, and it's kind of silly stupid. It's gonna be Poco at number two. Look, people group up so much at lower trophy levels. It's honestly really funny, and Poco just goes completely insane. A lot of random people at low trophy levels, you see three people running down the middle. This is like Poco's dream. He loves this. Oh my god, just three people running down the middle. So much damage. All of a sudden, Poco becomes the king of damage as someone who like does barely 1,000 damage per shot. Poco, oh my gosh, at lower trophy levels, Poco can do so much damage because people group up so much. If he's under 100 trophies, he could probably be number one on this list because of how often people group up. But even as you get a little bit higher, people still group up a lot, and they are not very good at not doing that, especially because people go with random so much and there's just not good coordination with their teams. So Poco is a really, really solid beginner brawler. At number one, it's gonna be Nita. Now, Nita is really easy to use for the most part. Star power isn't that important and is just really good regardless of whether you're a beginner or not. So that's definitely going to put Nita at number one. Nita's a really strong brawler, good in a lot of different modes, fairly easy to use. Yes, learning how to peek shot with Nita is a really good skill to become very good with Nita, but it's not entirely needed. You can auto-aim with Nita for pretty good success for the most part. It's not that important to be manual aiming all the time with Nita. So Nita, easy to use brawler, really good in a lot of different modes and good stats regardless, even good in non-beginner gameplay. So Nita is going to be the best brawler for beginners. Make sure to check out my other brawler rankings right over there. Tell me the best brawlers for every single mode. That's going to be it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll catch you later.